السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، وبه نستعين ونصلي ونسلم على أفضل الخلق أجمعين، نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه والتابعين ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين وبعد. Beloved brothers, sisters, dearest listeners, we thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for giving us this beautiful day of a Friday, which is the best day of the Islamic week. And at the same time, in it there is an hour where if we were to call out to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for any of our needs or anything that we would like, for as long as it is something permissible, the hadith says, it will be responded to exactly as we want it. What is that moment? I don't know and you don't know. Perhaps our best bet is to continue to make the dua from the morning to the evening. May Allah grant it to us. We all have our needs, we all have issues we are going through, we all may have medical problems. Nobody's life is rosy completely. And Allah knows what you are going through. You might think you are going through the biggest issues and the person sitting right next to you is going through a far bigger issue, but they are handling it well because they have iman. And because they have conviction. So we need to develop our iman and conviction. Remember, tests come to you and to me in order to make you closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mostly. And in order to develop you as a human being, many people do not turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when their life is rosy. Everything is going smooth. So they don't turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala because their bones are not aching. They don't have health matters. They look very good, mashallah. Their salary is 3-4 digit, alhamdulillah. And they are very excited, they have a good home, lovely place, lovely children, and they don't mind. So sometimes they don't read salah, and sometimes they don't even turn to Allah, and they have no purpose or reason, sometimes they think, to raise their hands to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. A mu'min should never feel this, no matter what you have. The more you have, the closer you should be to Allah. The more humble you should be, no matter what. When you are given a lot by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you need to turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And you need to make sure that you have thanked Him in every single way that He would like to be thanked. Because to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not only by mouth, but more than by mouth, it is by words and actions. What type of words? What type of actions? Those words that will please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Those actions that will please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. A person who says alhamdulillah 1,000 times every hour, yet he does not get up for salatul fajr, is ungrateful. A person who says, mashallah, oh Allah, I thank you, oh Allah, I appreciate what you've done for me, and they are not prepared to dress according to the law of Allah, they are ungrateful. They are showing ingratitude. So it's important to know and to realize that gratitude is shown through a certain channel. There is a certain way of showing gratitude. Gratitude is primarily shown in the way Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would like it to be seen from us. So your hands, your feet, your eyes, your nose, your faculties are all in synchronization towards the gratitude of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah has given us eyes. We look at 576 megapixel, the strength of my eyes, Allahu Akbar. What a powerful tool, what a powerful organ that Allah has given us. It requires no fine tuning. And alhamdulillah, Allah is the greatest. In order to thank Allah for that, I need to make sure I do not look at haram. Wallahi, that is the means of thanking Allah for your eyes. The minute you have looked at haram, whether it is in terms of the opposite sex, or in terms of something perhaps pornographic, something that is disallowed, and you have not lowered your gaze, or you have not protected yourself from looking at that which would earn the anger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in that case, we have not shown gratitude to Allah through or for the gift of the eyes we have. The same applies to our ears. My brothers and sisters, if we are busy listening to music, listening to swear words, allowing ourselves to listen to blasphemy and so on, with these ears of ours, we have not shown gratitude that we have ears. Ask those who cannot hear. I wonder how you will ask them, perhaps through signs. Allahu Akbar. They cannot hear. Ask those who need machinery in order to hear. May Allah grant shifa to all those who cannot hear. We need to show gratitude to Allah through listening to that which is within the obedience of Allah. So to show gratefulness for the gift of your ears, please listen to the Quran, listen to a good lecture, listen to the hadith, listen to something that will draw you closer to Allah. That is the gratitude for the ears you have. I have been given ears, not in order to sin through, so much so that my ears become frustrated with me. When I use them for something haram, they themselves will bear witness against me on the day of judgment. Ya Allah, I did not want to listen to this and to that, but this soul forced me to do that. Allahu Akbar. The same applies to my mouth. Wallahi, my beloved brothers and sisters, it is a very, very big gift of Allah. Do you know taste buds? Taste buds are such that no matter how hard we try to understand, we may understand up to a certain extent. Beyond that, we don't know. I was reading an article about salt, and they say something very strange. I actually was even more confused. They say salt does not add something, but it actually subtracts something to change the taste. Now, if you think about that, it is so confusing. When we add salt, perhaps to our hot chips, mashallah, what happens? We taste the salt. Now people are saying, you're not tasting something, you're actually subtracting something to make it taste like salt. Now, whether that is right or wrong, I don't know. But the statement itself brings about the qudra of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To say, your taste buds. Imagine you add something which is a little white powder and suddenly it tastes a certain way. And this is a gift of Allah. How have I thanked Allah for the gift of taste buds? Not only that, for my tongue. Whilst I'm speaking now, wallahi, my tongue is moving up and down hundreds of thousands of times. And I am not even thinking of how it is controlled. What is lifting it up and down? It's just overlooked because we do it so much. But a true mu'min will think about it from time to time.
إِنَّ فِي خَلْقِ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَاخْتِلَافِ اللَّيْلِ وَالنَّهَارِ لَآيَاتٍ لِأُولِي الْأَلْبَابِ الذين يذكرون الله قياما وقعودا وعلى جنوبهم ويتفكرون في خلق السماوات والأرض ربنا ما خلقت هذا باطلا سبحانك فقنا عذاب النار.
Amazing verse. Allah says, indeed, in the creation of the skies and the earth and the movement of the night and the day are signs for those with intellect. So everything Allah has created, there are signs in that for those with intellect. Signs of what? The presence of Allah. The fact that we are returning to Allah, who we are, why we've been created. And this is why Allah says, those who remember Allah whilst they are standing, whilst they are sitting, and on their sides, they remember Allah, they think of Allah, they think of everything Allah has given them, they think of returning to Allah, and when they think of returning to Allah, they say, oh Allah, protect us from the fire. Qina adhab an-nar. Oh Allah, protect us from the fire. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Why? Because that's where we are heading. How can I be thinking of all the creatures of Allah around me, and the gift of Allah, and whatever He's given us, and at the same time operate in my life in a way that when I end, or when this life comes to an end, I end up in the fire of Jahannam. Is that fair? No, it isn't. I need to use everything I have to make sure that I please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this gratitude, the gratitude of the ear we spoke about. We were speaking about the gratitude of the tongue. Remember, my brothers and sisters, utter words which will be pleasing to Allah. Praise Allah, declare it, with the meaning being believed in completely. There is no point in saying, Astaghfirullah, Astaghfirullah, whilst you are sinning. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us. A person who is saying, Astaghfirullah, or Allahu Akbar, or Alhamdulillah, and yet they are busy, engaged in a sin, or they do not want to give up a sin.
What are they doing? They have not understood the plan of Allah. They have not understood the respect of their own Rabb to start with. Your Rabb is here. You are saying Subhanallah, Alhamdulillah. And look at your deeds. They are heading in the wrong direction. My brothers and sisters, yesterday I attended a function and I thought of something that came to my mind. I need to share it with you because we don't know how long we're going to live. Non-Muslims who have been through all the evil that the world can offer have seen the light in Islam and turned to it. Why is it that we as Muslimin who have the gift of Islam and Iman, we want to test out and try out all those sins and evil, yet we have the best. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Look at Shaytan. This is why we should be crying when we hear the verse. Allah says, وَإِن تَتَوَلَّوْا يَسْتَبْدِلْ قَوْمًا غَيْرَكُمْ. If you are going to turn away, we will replace you with others, with another nation. Someone will take your place. If you did not come for Salatul Fajr, the masjid will not be empty. Someone else came where you were supposed to have been. Subhanallah. If you did not donate to a good cause, it's not going to stop. Someone else whose money was clean will donate. Like I was saying moments ago, for you to be able to listen to Haqq and the truth, you need to be worth it. If you're not worth it, someone else will come and listen to it. And you will be kicked out by Shaytan through some form of statement or rumor or whatever it is. And Allah kept you away because your deeds are not good enough. You are not serious about turning to Allah. Because Allah says, وَالَّذِينَ جَاهَدُوا فِينَا لَنَهْدِيَنَّهُمْ سُبُلَنَا. Whoever struggles and strives and makes an effort to come close to us, those are the ones whose doors of guidance we will open. We will open for them the guidance to us. Our paths will open. But someone making no effort, they have no intention, no plan to turn to Allah. Sometimes through Allah's miracle and mercy, He can still turn a person even from their bedside. He can do that. But the general rule, as He has said, you want something, you work towards it. You want something, you struggle towards it. I want paradise, and so do you. Wallahi, we want to meet in Jannah. I have love in my heart for everyone I see, by the will of Allah. Even if we may have a difference or two, even if you like purple and I like green, and so on. We love each other for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I want to see you in paradise, and I hope you have a similar feeling in your heart to see me in paradise. This is the brotherhood in Islam. Today, we have a small issue, a small difference. Instead of thinking, let me teach the brother. He is my brother. He is making a mistake. We become enemies. We hate each other. And yet, we are so close, just an inch away. If I could work half an inch and you could work half an inch, we would come together. But no, today we are taught something strange. And that is, when you do not like the way someone blinks, finished, cut them out of your life and start talking bad about them and walk in the other direction. Is that gratitude for the heart we've been given? Showing gratitude of the heart that Allah has given us to pump. It's amazing how, my brothers and sisters, Allah has kept the heart and He's spoken about two things regarding the heart. The heart is a physical heart and at the same time it is an emotional and spiritual heart. You need to know this. So when someone says your heart is clean, they could be talking of cholesterol. They could be talking of something physical. They could be talking of your blood being good and your heart is pumping. It depends who is saying that. If it is the cardiologist, he says your heart is very clean, pumping properly. You know what he's talking about. But if someone else is talking about, do you have a clean heart? They may be talking about your hatred, your jealousy, your enmity, a different type of cholesterol. And this is why we say develop a link with the ulama and the scholars. You must. If you do not have a link with the ulama and the scholars and you are lazy to attend the durus and the lessons that are there for you in the masajid and in various other places and platforms, if this laziness overtakes you, it develops a cholesterol that is spiritual in your heart. And you may suffer a spiritual heart attack by falling into zina and pornography and perhaps a relation with the opposite sex that will take you back 40 years in your relation with Allah. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why? Brother, you suffered a heart attack. There is paralysis on your right side. Not physical. Physically, you are in the gym and you are perhaps training. But the same gym has resulted in a certain type of cholesterol that blocked your spirituality. May Allah grant us gratitude. This is why we say when we talk of gratitude, it is such a broad topic that we need to think about it so deeply. Allah gave me a heart. I want it to pump. Today, if I told you, brother, your cholesterol is sitting at 9, you would say, what? 9, that is abnormal. What can I do? And you say, go on this diet and you better exercise this much. You must walk to work. You must do this. People walk for nothing. People walk for nothing just for their health. Which means they can walk 5 miles a day, 2 miles a day. And they can exercise and sweat on the spot. You know what that means? In reality, the only thing you're achieving is to try, T-R-Y, to improve your health in one way or another by running on the spot. You didn't even run somewhere, but on the spot. And you sweated so badly, but the same person cannot make it to the masjid. The same person cannot spend a moment to do tilawa. The same person cannot listen to the lectures, or perhaps cannot change their lives in a small way to please Allah. The same person who is ready to thin their blood through aspirin and dispirin is not prepared to thin their spiritual blood to protect themselves from spiritual cholesterol in order to earn the protection against a spiritual heart attack. And sometimes we really do deeds that result in a spiritual heart attack. One of them is jealousy, hatred, enmity, envy, selfishness, and so on. We need to be selfless. We need to learn to love one another. What I love for myself, I love for you. My brother, so what? There might be two or three things I may disagree with you on. But my brother, I love you for the sake of Allah. My sister, I love you for the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now it brings something to my mind. You have young people sometimes of the opposite sex. When they are a little bit religious and they want to tell someone they love them, they just add a statement at the end. They say, I love you, my sister. Then they say, for the pleasure of Allah, you know. If we're using that statement just to get to someone in a wrong way, wallahi, we are wrong. We shouldn't be. We make dua for one another. But the reality is, remove that hatred from your heart for others. Sometimes in our own family members, we have so much hatred. And then we say, I'm grateful to Allah. Alhamdu wa shukru lillah. Laka alhamdu wa laka shukru ya wajidu. Jalla jalaluk. What is it enough to say the statement, or do you really mean it? If you really mean it, concentrate on your heart, your hands. Like we are speaking about the heart right now, and I'm saying how important it is to engage in, say for example, the dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the remembrance of Allah. The Quran is afdalul dhikr. And at the same time, to purify the heart from clinging towards worldly material items in a way that you are taken away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Some people love their hair more than they love Allah. Some people love their face more than they love Allah. Some people love their car more than they love Allah. Some people their watch, they love it more than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Some people, they love someone who is haram for them more than Allah. So they will go in that direction. And when the muadhin says, Hayya alal falah, come to success. Where are they? They are there. Haram relation. Someone somewhere. They turn a deaf ear to the call to success more than 20 times a day. More than 20 times a day. I think people are working out. How did you get to that? Don't worry. You can calculate it. If we are wrong, you can downgrade. You can revise. But even if it was a call once a day, who is calling you to falah? What is falah? Success. Don't you want the pounds? I want them too. Well, you want them? Hayya ala al-falah. The owner of the pounds is telling you, come, I show you. Come, come here. I will give you what is right for you. If I gave you more, you might use it in the wrong way. If I gave you less, you might have this. If I give you more, you might forget me. So I've given you what you deserve. And I've given you such that I keep you where I want you to be. Subhanallah. May Allah grant us qana'ah, happiness. May He make us convinced and content. So this is success. You want goodness in the dunya and the akhirah. Here it is. Salah does not only help you in this dunya, but it helps you in the akhirah as well. Or let's word it the other way. Salah does not only help you for the life after death. Wallahi, it opens your doors here as well. When you close your eyes and your heart from haram, Allah opens your eyes and heart to His nur. Subhanallah. It's the nur of Allah. But the minute you have haram going on in your life, it's ingratitude. You are ungrateful for your hands. Allah has given me a basma. You know what is a basma? It is a fingerprint. My fingerprint is different from everyone who existed from the time of Adam alayhi salam to today. And you know what? If I had to burn my finger totally that I lost my fingerprint, when it grew again or grows again, it will grow exactly as it was. Did you ever know that? Subhanallah, Subhanal Khaliq. If you were to burn it sometimes And if it were to grow again, it will grow exactly how it was. It is your unique identity from the beginning of creation. Nobody can say that this is someone else. That is your unique identity. Qudra of Allah. Can I tell you something else that I've read? The way your iris is actually shaped and made, the combination of the cones and the rods and so on, is unique from the time of Adam alayhi salam to this day. Unique totally. So now they have an iris identification. You go there, you show them your eye. Allahu Akbar. And you think you are going to run away from Allah. And you think you are going to run away from Allah when you've sinned and you need to answer. They will see you, they know you, even when you are resurrected. Who knows, your thumbprint may be that which will give you away. Allahu Akbar. May Allah protect us. I read something very recent, and that is, if you were to shave your head completely, the way in which your hairs grow through your head is totally unique. Nobody else's hairs of the head have grown with that design that you have on your head. Subhanallah. Although some of us are bald, the rest of what is remaining. Alhamdulillah. So my brothers and sisters, thank Allah for this. He's given us so much. How can I use my hands to touch haram? But I can tell you, ingratitude is closely connected to haram earnings. When a person's earning is not halal, his entire body is nourished through that which is haram. So how do you think his eyes are going to be quenched? Except through haram. He will not be happy when he looks at his wife and his children. He will be agitated. He wants to get out. Why? Because he needs to look at something haram before he says, wow, astaghfirullah. He will not be happy when he touches what he is supposed to be touching until he touches that which is haram. He will not be happy to walk to the masjid because it will be an irritation, agitation. Because the energy being used in order to walk to the masjid was derived from a haram source. It will only be satisfied when it walks in the wrong direction. So this is why sometimes people say, I don't know, I feel so lazy when it comes to doing that which Allah wants. And I feel so excited when it comes to doing haram. Al-qalbu yanshatu lil-qabihi wa kam yanamu anil hasan. Ya nafsu wayhaki malladhi yurdiki fi dunya al-afan. Allahu Akbar. The heart becomes, you know, the bad heart becomes so energetic when it comes to commit haram, and it slows down when it comes to engaging in the worship of Allah and that which is good. Oh soul, remember, what is going to please you in this life that is coming to an end? What is going to please you? Prepare for the day that you meet Allah by being grateful. Show gratitude, your hands, your legs, your brain, your mind. The thoughts you have, let them be clean. That is gratitude of the brain, the mind. Subhanallah. Today, the mind can be used for several things. Some people sit and plan haram. If that's the case, my brother, my sister, your brain is not being used towards the gratitude of Allah. And some people use their brain in order to help the rest of humanity. Alhamdulillah. So you've come up with technology, you've come up with ideas, you've come up with what to do on the net in order to help people and so on. Alhamdulillah, if you're doing it with the right intention, we will say you will receive a reward for that. It's good because to help one another is part and parcel of your duty as a Muslim. Some people's brain is solely and only used towards the pleasure of Allah. Alone, only. So they will sit and think of the verses of the Quran, think of the signs of Allah, engage in the dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, do that which really will please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Good news to them, may we be from amongst them as well. Now you have your mind in order. When your mind is in order, your eyes, your ears, everything else, your income, everything becomes in order. Bearing in mind the close link between your mind and your heart. This is why Allah says, in the Quran, in several places, He connects the heart and the mind. And He says, they have a heart which they don't think by. So sometimes the heart is used in order to refer to thinking. And sometimes the mind is used in order to be referred to feeling. The two are very closely connected. Al-qalbu wal-aqlu. Very closely connected. Why? Because the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam says that in the body there is a piece of flesh. If that piece of flesh is pure and good and clean, the whole body will be pure and good and clean. And if that piece of flesh is dirty and unclean, the whole body will be dirty and unclean. He says, that piece of flesh is the heart. If you look at that hadith, it's the hadith of Nu'man ibn Bashir radiallahu anhu in Sahih Muslim. It's a very powerful hadith. I'm sure a lot of us would know it. But did you ever think there are two meanings to it? And they are both correct. Your heart pumps what? It pumps blood. If your heart is clean and the blood in it is clean, your body is physically also correct. Which means when you are sick, what do? They need a blood test. Why? Because of that hadith. Allahu Akbar. Did you think of that? They need a blood test. And with a blood test, they can tell you anything. Even if your kidneys are not operating, the blood test will tell. Anything not operating, your blood test will tell. Why? There's a hadith. The Prophet says, if the heart is okay, and the blood that is obviously being pumped in it, everything else is okay. If it's not, it's not. So we take the spiritual meaning, which is definitely the initial and original meaning. But we want to show you the miracle in the words of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. It has a physical meaning to it as well. Subhanallah. So now when you go for a blood test, you can think to yourself, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala open our doors, grant us goodness and ease. And really, I hope and I pray these few words that I've uttered are words of comfort for us. We ask Allah to help us to show gratitude to Him. And at the same time, we really would like to be better people for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wa sallallahu wa sallam wa baraka ala nabina Muhammad.